Hello, today I will show you how to insert data in database through PyMongo. At first you need to put your cluster URL like this. Then you need to put your database name like this. After that you write to a simple code such as insert example. Look at insert example. That is a simple body records db dot rtest. Rtest means rtest means collection name, and this is my data that will be inserted in my database. Then simply call insert one and the new student object. So I'm going to hit this URL. At first you see the database. There in rtest collection there was a one document, so I want to hit another. This is the my link, and the your insert example function executes successfully. So after that one document will be inserted in my database. So I refresh it. See, the next document will be inserted successfully. So in this process we insert document successfully in my database. At first you need to few step. You need to install DNS. I will show you. DNS Python. You need to install this module DNS Python. I will give you in the comment section how to install DNS Python. So in this process we successfully insert document into my database. Thank you.
Host a project and point it to a domain using Amazon S3, simple storage services and cloud phone services. So what we need to do in the first place, we have to be logged into the AWS management console and we need to go to the certificate manager. The certificate manager is region specific, since I need it in US East 1. Need to select the region. And here all of my registered domains are listed. I have already added my certificate in this listing, that is why my certificate has been issued. I don't have to do it again. If you want to learn how to issue a certificate, there's another video. You can go and consult that and come back. So today what we are going to do, we are going to deploy a project with this domain name. Okay, then you can go to the Amazon S3 service and create a bucket with the same domain name that we want. I want to unblock all public access since I want to run this bucket to host a website, I have to unblock all public access and they will show a warning. We need to acknowledge it and then create the bucket. After we create the bucket, we can go ahead and enter it. We need to go on the permissions and we can see in our bucket policy, we need to give it some access. We can go to the documentation to get the policy. In the policy, there are various policy examples that we need to visit. In the policy, we will be granting read-only permission to any anonymous user. So we need to copy this whole template and paste it here on our bucket policy. And under view resources, we have to replace our bucket name. Our head is given as example bucket. Of course, we need to change it to our bucket name. And save it. Then our bucket has public access. Now we need to go and enter the properties and static website hosting. Here we need to enable static website hosting and give them the index document. So since we are using this Angular project and my index document is index.html, we need to mention it. Once we are done with that, we can save it. And the bucket is currently hosting right now. What we need on that, we need the endpoint URL. So we will copy this and keep it. Then we are going to enter the CloudFront services. In the CloudFront distribution, we will create a new distribution, a web distribution to be exact. The endpoint we have copied, we will paste over here, and the origin path will be automatically taken, origin ID will be taken. What we want to do is redirect HTTP calls to HTTPS, so we'll select this. Over here, we want to compress our objects. This is equivalent to gzip. And our alternate domain name. Here again, we need to paste our domain name in order for this to work. We do have a custom SSL certificate that we have registered in the ACM, so we can go over here and select that state certificate. And default root object over here, of course, again we have to mention index.html. And over here in the comment section, I'm pasting this to notify so that I can easily find which CloudFront distribution was created to point this project. And we will create a distribution. CloudFront acts as a request handler while the S3 bucket acts as a storage device in this whole system. We can see that this bucket, our CloudFront, is being deployed. It's enabled, but unless it is deployed, you won't be able to see any changes.